Hello guys, and welcome to a brand new LP, and I'm finally able to bring this to you. I tried playing it, as you know, and I struggled with running the game. It wasn't running, and the creator of this mod, this Mortal Knight mod, Resident Evil Nemesis 30, has released the rebirth mode using Resident Evil Source. So instead of it being a standalone mod, which was struggling to even run, we've now got a new game, or a new version of it, which actually runs, and I'm able to run. So shout out to the creator of this mod, brilliant guy. He's done amazing with this mod. This is only the first episode at the moment, so hopefully soon he'll be releasing the newer versions. If I play this one and I manage to do it all right, I probably will go back to the older version and do episode two. But this seems to set up differently. The doors seem to lead to different areas. I'm not familiar with all this, so this is completely blind. I'm gonna go with arranged mode because I'm not sure how easy or how hard this is. I might just I don't know what, so I'm gonna go normal. This game is difficult. You can pick up items from enemies, from what I understand, and I'm gonna go quiet now and let you enjoy the opening cutscene.
A bizarre incident occurred in the outskirts of an American suburb called Raccoon City. It was later revealed that the terrible disaster had been caused by the T-virus, a mutagenic toxin created by the International Enterprise Umbrella Incorporated for use in bioweapon experiments. The Raccoon City Police Department's Special STARS Unit immediately began investigation in the affair. The case was apparently closed, thanks to the efforts of STARS members Chris Redfield and Jill Valentine. But the Umbrella Corporation's experiments were far from finished.
Raccoon City. Another victim of the government's corruption. Another victim of Umbrella's ambition. Another lost home for decent people. It all started in the Arclay Mountains, in a forgotten mansion in the depths of the forest. The STARS teams died because of their unwillingness to believe what their eyes were telling them. The creatures of that cursed residence were strong, and the darkness even stronger. Two members of the USS were sent to clean every trace of Umbrella. Their mission was successful, and the forest burned with the mansion. No one knew what happened there. No one knew of Umbrella's guilt. Raccoon City. An ordinary American Midwest town. An ordinary population. Good people who became animals. All caused by Umbrella, the world's largest international enterprise. William Birkin developed the G-virus in Umbrella's underground lab, and in the process, he became a monster. A monster that caused the spread of the virus throughout the city. And as the city fell, the virus evolved. Umbrella's best agent, Hunk, killed Birkin and acquired a G-virus sample. But the sample had been contaminated. The government planned to sterilize the city with an atomic bomb, but Umbrella used its influence to delay the strike. One of their satellites had discovered that Sherry, daughter of William Birkin, was still alive in the city's police station. Umbrella thought that Dr. Birkin may have infected the young girl with the virus, so a team from the USS was deployed with orders to secure Sherry Birkin. Once they completed their mission, the city would be incinerated.
So I think that's a slightly different intro to before. And this is definitely different. This was not in the other one that I tried when I actually did get it to work, because for some reason it glitches out. This is the press office from Resident Evil 3. Alright, so this is some tips for playing Mortal Knight. So we're gonna read, there are new item combinations. You should try and combine items that may not be related, that may be related in some way. Check everything, furniture, corpses, NTPs, decoration, etc. You may find useful items that will make things easier. Some enemies, normal, uncommon ones, may drop ammo and healing. Check the bodies. You can skip most cutscenes by pressing the confirm button. Do not do this in the first playthrough though, you may miss more information. Use the knife or shoot enemies or weak spots in order to save ammo. Press F9 to exit the game. Please read the instructions for more details. Now the game is randomised, which means that every time you play there are chances that you will not find the same enemies, cutscenes or items or solution for puzzles. Your choices in the order in which you go in different areas of the RPG will differ, will affect what you will face. Now is some gunpowder in the game that combines the following: A and B, A and A is handgun, A and B is magnum, B and A is shotgun, and B and B is grenade guns. And that's all. The game needs to be played a minimum of 4 times if you want to see nearly every single change in gameplay. Remember that it will be determined by choice versus luck. Enjoy. So, this game, in terms of what he's done with it, it's really good. I've managed to get the game to work with, and as you can see, my guns are not brilliant. I've got 5% on my main gun. I don't really understand why. I did notice when I was testing this yesterday that when I went through a certain area, I was able to kill the enemies fairly decently with this knife, which is really, really, really strange. And we're just gonna check around to make sure there's nothing in here. Sorry, I didn't mean to skip that. Right. So when we go back in this room in a minute, these enemies will wake up. I did manage to get to the PlayStation, but because the game is very, very different. You might notice some of these sounds are actually from Code Veronica. Oh. also skip doors as well. I saw something flashing. The G-Virus sample that Agent Hunt managed to extract from under our underground laboratory was contaminated beyond use. We will use all our resources available to delay the nuclear missile launch in order to allow the Umbrella Security Services and Security Service to team to secure a new G-Virus sample. It's very likely that the corpse of Dr. Birkin, the scientist responsible for the creation of the G-Virus, has continue to spread infection throughout the city, including our laboratory and sewers, and even the Raccoon City Police Department. We have also confirms safe state little imagining that there are still life forms in the RPD. Fortunately, we were able to capture some of images of Sherry Birkin, daughter of Dr. Birkin, confirmed that she is alive and being held up in the police department. It's most likely that Dr. Birkin infected his daughter with the G-Virus. Since we cannot be sure of how far along the infection is, we are going to be dividing in teams into the team in two units. Alpha team will clear the sewers and the laboratory of infected creatures and extract, produce, collecting biological samples of the remaining corpses as they go. Meanwhile, Omega team will focus on collecting Sherry from the RPD. It doesn't matter whether she is alive or dead, or she is already mutated. We must have her brought back to our European facility for the G-Virus extraction by sales and organs. Once both operations are completed, we will reunite under the ground laboratory and we'll use the cargo train to escape the facility. We have the helicopters waiting at the extraction point to escort teams out of the sea. Missile will be launched at dawn. There will be no further delays, to act quickly. Right. I don't know if going back in here is actually going to be worth it. Come on! Get off! Anyone going to get up. Oh, get off! Right, this was normally the way to the police station, but it's been changed for this particular one. I got to the police station before, as you might remember, and in here, we've finally, also in this version, typewriters have been fixed. I remember the reason why I never played this game properly was for one simple reason. The typewriters didn't work. You had no way of saving. Absolutely zero way of saving. You couldn't save, in other words. It was next to impossible. Chances of you being able to save and save well was very, 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 very small. So this was my test sort of run, so I'm going to save it over this. So I am in this. It's really cool. I love the fact that this game has been, this mod has been done using the old Resident Evil. It brings a whole lease of life. And maybe, you know, one day, if they might recruit Resident Evil Nemesis 30, rather, to, you know, maybe adapt this game more. Where's this going?
Blew himself up. Come what on. An idiot.
You idiot!
Alright guys, sorry about that cut. Shit, what? Password. Six, two, two, three, three. Thank you. Oh, fuck. They not seem to be giving me anything, so... I don't know whether or not to save it or not. I think I probably can do that again if I die, so I'm just gonna continue. Oh, so that bitch has been added for a new sort of era where you meet Davis instead of in the basketball court. That makes sense. I thought it was a whole different area. Oh shit! For that. I'm fucked. Look at me. I've got no health now. Oh. And we now start as Alyssa, I think she is. Never got through that bit unscathed before. I can't remember how you get in this fucking room. Shit, it's definitely enough. I have to stay here. The street is full of zombies. Okay, so that was a very, very short bit. But I'm glad I got through it. All I need to worry about is just... getting a full cure. Scared the shit out of me. Okay, let's write this down. Up. So, up. Right. Up, right, down. Up, right, down. Left, down, last from downstairs. Whoa! Jesus Christ! I was not expecting you in here. Oh dear. I didn't just skip it, did I? No, I don't think I did. Oh, it's the wrong... I love how he's changed some of the doors here. I think it's really cool. What the? door was never here before. Note from Marvin. Hey guys, in case that there's any of you left alive out there, you must, under no sense, enter the room I've just sealed with wooden boards. There's something we've never seen in there. He's some kind of super monster. He has been killed. He's killed three of us, and we couldn't stop it. This is madness. I'm infected, so I won't be maintaining this museum overview for long. If you want to release the electronic locks, you must find the key card and reroute the power in the basement, but some systems will stop working. I don't recommend it end it to you, but if you have to do it, that's the way. Best of luck. Yeah, I'm mega slow at the minute. All I need to find is just something. I think I will die. And if I do, then I'll just have to start from where I died before. Where does this go? What the hell? Huh? This is the fucking basement for Resident Evil 1! No, it's not. Yes, it is. No, this is one. This is 1.5, I think. I want to go and save it, and I think I'm going to. Whoa! This game is unforgiving. I might not do this bit again. I might just go back to the last save and try and get to this point without being so damaged on health, because one hit and I'm screwed. Right, I'm gonna go and check out one of these other doors before we finish this video. It's been quite a long one. I've actually done two split videos, so. Is there going to be a health item in here? Alright, well, that's a good place to stop. So, guys, that's it. That's the end. We've died. That is not easy at all. That is a tough, tough, tough thing to do. Yeah. Very hard. All right, guys. That's it. That's the end of that for now. So, thanks for watching, guys. If you want to see more of this, be sure to let me know. And we will continue on next time. So, thanks for watching. And I'll see you next time. Thank you.